The question of money was never even raised. The whole issue was to raise enough money to go. The reward was putting on the Malaysian singlet, standing there and, you know, listening to the anthem if you had a chance, and seeing the flag raised. Hopes are that, you know, Malaysia has never won a gold medal. Our badminton players have won silvers and our diver has got a bronze, so we have been on the podium. So perhaps, you know, one looks forward to having a gold medalist. So maybe this is the time. The Malaysian sportsmen today are treated very well, actually, and they have a lot of support. Scholarships are not hard to get if they have the academic qualifications. They get preferences and so on. So I think Malaysia has put together in place all these things, you know. So I don't think we can say that the support is not being given in these terms. But what may be needed more is the building of the culture from very young. And equally important is that while these external things are being given, the environment that will produce the inner resilience, that will make winners and what they like sometimes in the sporting circles to describe as the killer instinct, you know. So this takes a long time to build. And you can't teach it in a training camp. And to be fair, the biggest thrill we get was when our leaders, people like Tunku Abdul Rahman, Tun Razak, Tun Sambandan, you win the Asian Games, they'll send you a handwritten letter. Dear Jega, the country is proud of you. Well done.